Hello buddies. Today, I have planned to test safety alarms and trips for Incinerator. Okay, let's start. As first, furnace high pressure alarm will test. Switch on cooling fan of Incinerator. After then, disconnect Teflon tube from copper tube. At that time, furnace pressure high alarm activates and burner trip. Before reset alarm, reconnect Teflon tube to copper tube, likes normal condition. Press buzzer stop and alarm reset buttons to deactivate alarm. As second test, let's try cooling fan at normal alarm. Open cover of incinerator control panel. After then, press trip switch of thermal relay for cooling fan. Cooling fan abnormal alarm activates and burner trips. Before reset alarm on panel, firstly press reset button on thermal relay. Now, let's test misfire or flame failure alarms. Press combustion button for incinerating. Remove cover of flame eye sensor. After then, pull out flame eye and expose surface to light. Misfire alarm activates and burner trips. Before reset alarm, mount flame eye to its original position and close cover of flame eye to prevent damaging. After then, press buzzer stop and alarm reset buttons. As fourth of testing, you can see how to test exhaust gas high temperature. As first, press combustion button and starts incinerating. Reduces setting of exhaust gas thermostat dial. Exhaust gas high temperature alarm activates and burner tripped. After then, reset setting value of thermostat to 320 degrees centigrade. Lock thermostat dial to prevent shifting. Press buzzer stop and alarm reset buttons like before. Now, burner fan abnormal alarm will test. As first, press combustion button and starts incineration. Press trip switch of burner motor relay. Burner fan abnormal alarm activates and combustion stops. And then, press reset switch on relay. Reset alarm on panel. Before we test atomize air pressure low, press combustion button and starts incinerating. Pull out lock of reducing valve. After then, turn adjusting knob and reduce pressure to 40 kPa. Atomize air pressure low alarm activates and combustion stop. After testing alarm, increase atomize air pressure to 80 kPa and push handle to lock. After then, reset button is on panel. Let's stop incinerator alarms testing in here. See you in part 2 of incinerator alarms testing. Please don't forget like and subscribe. Thanks.